Hello, myself M S Basargaon, Assistant Professor, Department of Humanities and Sciences, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to express Fourier series of even and odd function in the interval minus pi to pi. Now we'll see the examples. Find the Fourier series of x is equal to sin ax in the interval minus pi to pi. Now here, f of x is equal to sin ax. Now first of all, we will test the even and odd function. Now here f of minus x, that is replacing x by minus x, we get f of minus x equal to sin of minus ax, which is equal to minus sin ax, that is equal to minus f of x. Hence f of minus x is equal to minus f of x, therefore f of x equal to sin ax is an odd function. And for odd function, a naught is equal to 0 and an equal to 0. The Fourier series of an odd function is given by f of x is equal to summation of n equal to 1 to infinity bn sin nx, where bn is equal to 2 by pi integration from 0 to pi sin ax sin nx dx. Now before integrating, we make use of the formula of sin a sin b. Now which is equal to 2 by pi integration from 0 to pi cos of a minus nx minus cos of a plus nx whole divided by 2 dx. Here 2 will get cancelled. And here we know the since sin a sin b is equal to cos of a minus b minus cos of a plus b divided by 2, which is equal to 1 by pi. Now we'll integrate with respect to x, that is integration of cos a minus nx is sin a minus nx divided by a minus n, and integration of cos of a plus nx is, that is minus sin of a plus nx by a plus n with the limit 0 to pi, which is equal to, now putting the upper limit 1 by pi, sin of a minus n pi by a minus n minus sin of a plus n pi divided by a plus n. And for lower limit, as you know, sin 0 is 0, therefore for lower limit you get 0, which is equal to 1 by pi. Now expounding sin of a minus n pi, you get sin a pi cos n pi minus cos a pi sin n pi, that is by using the formula of sin a minus b divided by a minus n minus, now expounding sin of a plus n pi, that is sin a pi cos n pi plus cos a pi sin n pi divided by a plus n, which is equal to, we can write 1 by pi, we know cos of n pi is minus 1 raised to n, and sin a pi as it is divided by a minus n. And as we know, sin of n pi is 0, therefore this second term will be 0 minus here, again cos of n pi is minus 1 raised to n, keeping sin a pi as it is, and sin n pi is again 0 divided by a plus n, since sin n pi is 0 and cos n pi is minus 1 raised to n. Now simplifying this, we get minus 1 raised to n sin a pi by pi into bracket 1 by a minus n minus 1 by a plus n, which is equal to minus 1 raised to n sin a pi divided by pi into bracket a plus n minus a plus n divided by a square minus n square, that taking the cross multiplication and multiplying a minus n and a plus n, which is equal to, here a will get cancelled, 2n minus 1 raised to n sin a pi divided by pi into bracket a square minus n square. Hence f of x is equal to 2 sin a pi divided by pi summation of n equal to 1 to infinity minus 1 raised to n into n divided by a square minus n square sin nx. Now pause the video for a while and find the Fourier series of f of x equal to x in the interval minus pi to pi. I hope you have completed. Here f of x is equal to x, and clearly here f of x equal to x is an odd function. Hence a naught is equal to 0 and an equal to 0. The Fourier series of an odd function is given by f of x equal to summation of n equal to 1 to infinity bn sin nx, where bn is equal to 2 by pi integration from 0 to pi f of x sin nx dx, which is equal to 2 by pi integration from 0 to pi x sin nx dx. Now we can integrate this integral with respect to x by using generalized rule of integration by part, which is equal to 2 by pi, keeping x as it is, and integration of sin nx is minus cos nx by n minus derivative of x is 1, and integration of minus cos nx by n is minus sin nx by n square with the limit 0 to pi, which is equal to 2 by pi, putting the upper limit that x equal to pi as pi minus cos n pi by n minus minus plus sin of n pi is 0, and if you put lower limit because of multiplication of x, we get first term is 0 and sin of 0 is also 0, which is equal to, we get the minus sign, minus 2 into cos of n pi is minus 1 raised to n divided by n, and here pi pi will get cancelled. Therefore, f of x is equal to summation of n equal to 1 to infinity minus 2 into minus 1 raised to n divided by n sin nx. Now we'll see one more example. Find the Fourier series of f of x is equal to 1 plus 2x by pi when minus pi is less than or equal to x is less than or equal to 0, and which is equal to 1 minus 2x by pi when 0 is less than or equal to x is less than or equal to pi. And hence deduce that pi square by 8 is equal to 1 by 1 square plus 1 by 3 square plus 1 by 5 square plus so on. Now here, first of all, you will test here the for even and odd function. For that, you replace here x by minus x, that is f of minus x is equal to 1 minus 2x by pi, that is by replacing x by minus x, where minus pi is less than or equal to, again here also replacing x by minus x, that you get minus x less than or equal to 0, or we can write this inequality as 0 is less than or equal to x is less than or equal to pi, which is equal to, now here replacing x by minus x, we get 1 plus 2x by pi, where 0 is less than or equal to minus x is less than or equal to pi. The same inequality can be written as minus pi is less than or equal to x is less than or equal to 0. Now you look at the given function f of x and f of minus x, we are getting the same. Therefore, here f of minus x is equal to f of x. Therefore, f of x is an even function, hence the value of bn is 0. Now the Fourier series of an even function is given by f of x is equal to a naught plus summation of n equal to 1 to infinity an cos nx, where a naught is equal to 1 by pi integration from 0 to pi f of x dx, which is equal to 1 by pi integration from 0 to pi, in the interval 0 to pi f of x is 1 minus 2x by pi dx, which is equal to 1 by pi, and integration of 1 is x minus 2 by pi into x square by 2, that is 2 will get cancelled, you get minus x square by pi with the limit 0 to pi, which is equal to 1 by pi, putting x equal to pi, you get pi minus pi square by pi, and for lower limit both the terms are 0, that you get pi minus pi, which is equal to 0. Here a naught is also 0. Now we'll calculate an. An is equal to 2 by pi integration from 0 to pi f of x cos nx dx, which is equal to 2 by pi integration from 0 to pi, here f of x is 1 minus 2x by pi cos nx dx. Now integrating by using generalized rule of integration by part, taking u as a 1 minus 2x by pi and v as a cos nx, we'll integrate, which is equal to 2 by pi, keeping 1 minus 2x by pi as it is, and integration of cos nx is sin nx by n minus the derivative of 1 minus 2x by pi is minus 2 by pi, and integration of sin nx by n is minus cos nx by n square with the limit 0 to pi. Now putting the upper limit, putting x equal to pi, we know sin of n pi is 0, therefore the first term is 0, and here minus into minus into minus, we get the minus sign, twice cos of n pi by pi n square. Now minus of lower limit, as you know sin 0 is 0, therefore this term is 0, then minus cos 0 is 1, that is we get minus 2 upon pi n square. Now here taking 2 by pi n square common, we get, which is equal to 4 by n pi square n square into bracket 1 minus minus 1 raised to n, Hence, f of x is equal to 4 by pi square, summation of n equal to 1 to infinity, 1 minus minus 1 raised to n by n square cos nx. Now, here putting the values of n, we get 4 by pi square. Putting n equal to 1, we get the value of 1 minus minus 1 raised to n as a 2, 2 by n square means 1 square cos x plus. Now, here for n equal to 2, we get the value of this as a 0, and for n equal to 3, you get 2, that is 2 by 3 square cos 3x. Similarly, putting n equal to 4, you get the value of this bracket is 0, and for n equal to 5, you get 2, that is 2 by 5 square cos of 5x plus so on, which is equal to taking 2 common here, 8 by pi square into bracket 1 by 1 square cos x plus 1 by 3 square cos 3x plus 1 by 5 square cos 5x and so on. Now, to get the one more result, here we have to put x equal to 0 in equation number 1, that we get f of 0 from the given function. F of 0 is 1, which is equal to 8 by pi square. As we know, the values of cos 0 are 1, that is, we get 1 by 1 square plus 1 by 3 square plus 1 by 5 square plus so on, and by simplifying get, therefore, pi square by 8 is equal to 1 by 1 square plus 1 by 3 square plus 1 by 5 square and so on. Now, references, Higher Engineering Mathematics by Dr. B.S. Grewal.